Hello all, welcome to AuraTrainings.com. In this session, we'll discuss about a calendar page in Oracle Apex. Okay, let's get into agenda. So in this session, we'll discuss about these particular following topics, like a creation of a calendar page via table using a SQL query, and how do we either view or update the task, and how do we drag and drop a task, and how do we apply a CSS to a particular task. And also we'll try to get the Oracle provided calendar sample app so that we can also get some information from that. So I'll navigate to the Apex website, apex.oracle.com. Okay. So now what we do is the first thing, we'll try to discuss about how do we create a calendar app, a calendar page using a table. Okay. So go to SQL Workshop, Object Browser. And one important thing when you want to create a calendar pages, it requires two date columns. One is start date and another one is end date. It is not about the column name, but it is about two date columns which should be there. Okay. So in my example, I prefer to use a particular table called EBA demo qual projects, or you'll also have something called, if you just search with the name EBA projects, will also be there. So I prefer to use this one. Okay. If it is not there, I'll tell you how we get that. But for now, assume that you have this one. Or if you don't have any of these particular table, you can just create a table with the information like a task name, start date, end date, and also have a primary key. Okay, that's a major important thing. Now, once you navigate to SQL Workshop Object Browser, what you do is simply click on Create App. And then click on again, Create App. Now, so it mentions an application name. So I'll just mention demo qual projects version 2. Okay. And here by default here, if you observe, it generates a calendar page for us. It generates a calendar page as well as a search page, as well as a project a report page also it will generate. Okay. Interactive report with the form it will generate. Okay. I mean, of course, these three things I can say, faceted search and interactive report with the form as well as calendar page. But our major interest was calendar page, but let the other pages also will get generated. And now click on Create Application. Okay, so now run the application and let's see how it looks like. And log in. Okay, so this is how a calendar page in Apex looks like. Okay, now we'll apply some of the functionalities like edit page as well as view page, nothing but let us say here, if you observe, if I just mouse over on any of the task, I'm not getting the major details. Like let us say I want to edit this task, or let us say on this Wednesday, I want to create a task. Okay. So how do we do that? Right. So here, if you observe, just click on this particular navigation bar, hamburger. And here, if you observe, we know that when we created a project, when we create an application, we got these set of pages which were generated. Now I'll click on report. Demo call projects report. And here, if you observe, I'll just try to click on edit. Now we already have a form which was generated when we are creating an application. So what we do is we'll try to reuse this particular form in our calendar page. And here, if you observe, what is the page name, the page ID? It is page 5, right? So this particular form is with a page ID 5. So if I open this particular form with ID, it has to show the existing data. If I does not pass anything, it will create a new record for us, right? So we'll try to reuse this particular form in our calendar page. So what is the form ID? It is 5. So what we'll do is now here, which is our calendar page? So our calendar page is this one, 6th one. So I'll click on this one. And here on this particular one, calendar, the title is calendar and even the type is calendar. Now what we want to do is we just want to edit that. We want to link that, right? So here, okay. So click on attributes. Yeah, one important thing is here it did not set it properly, right? So here if you observe, it did not set the end date properly. So let us view our calendar again. Let me click on cancel calendar. Okay. Let me rerun first of all. Okay. Yeah, it is working fine, but generally this should have it, the information. So end date should be there. So now again, and also primary key, it was not set. Make sure that you set the primary key also. Okay, this is very important. Click on save and rerun it. So if at all, if those particular columns were not set properly, make sure you set them properly. Now, next thing what we want to do is we just want to go to the form, project report, edit. And what is the form ID? The page ID is nothing but 5. So we'll navigate to the calendar page. And here on the attributes, we have two things, but two very important things to work with the links, right? One is create link, other one is edit link, view or edit link. So the first thing is I'll click on create link, nothing but if at all, let me navigate there in the calendar page. Let us say if I just simply click on any of the date, if it is empty, it will open our form with the empty data. Okay. Now click on link here and which page it is 5. And what is so it is a create link, right? So there is nothing. And also for this also, 5, that's it. Now for the edit link, and here also it is 5. And here also if 5 in the clear cache. Now here in the set item, in the target page, P4 ID, and in the source page, what is the one? ID column, right? Ampersand ID. And period, ampersand ID dot, or I can say. Now click on OK. Now save it and run the page. Now we can observe what is the functionality got changed. Now on this Wednesday, I'll just simply click on here, create the task. Okay. Apex sample task. Apex project. And I'll select start date is 7th. End date is maybe a 9th, status NA as of now. Click on create. Okay. Can you see the Apex project? It started from this date to this date. Okay, 7th to 9th. Can you just click on this again? Let us say I want to change the date. Let us say I want to start from this week and I'll select Sunday. From 3rd to 9th, I want to change it. Now just click on apply changes. You should see the changes now. Can you see? This got changed from 3rd to 9th, 38th, I mean, 38th or 9th. Yeah, sorry, it was 8th. Let us say I'll change to 9th. Okay. So this is how the changes works. We could able to see the existing one, or we could able to create the new one, right? Now, what is the other thing I want to show is, now here if you observe, we'll discuss this last, the SQL query. And now the next thing is we have discussed about the view as well as update task, right? And now I'll try to understand what is this drag and drop task. Now here, this calendar functionality provides, you can drag and drop a particular task onto a new date. Let us say, assume that I created a particular task. A task on this date, I want to drag and drop into some other date, which I'm comfortable. Okay, nothing but I want to change the start date, end date of a particular task. Okay. Now, how do we do that? So for this one here, if you observe, first of all, you have to enable drag and drop checkbox. And once you enable the drag and drag checkbox, it asks you what is the PL SQL code behind it you want to consider. So what you have to do is, it's very simple. So now very important functionality is when you create a calendar, Oracle Apex provides a bind variable, which will hold the value of this particular start date and end date. And also primary key. So colon apex dollar new start date will have the start date information, colon apex new end date will have the end date information, and also ID is a primary key which will have the information about the primary key of that particular record. Just copy this one. Now you just paste in this particular PL SQL block, validate this and click on OK. Okay. Now we'll just click on save. Now run it. Okay. Now we can I'll drag and drop this onto this one, right? Now it is allowing to drag and drop. Now let us say this task, I want to make it on this one, Wednesday, right? That's it. Okay. So this is how we can drag and drop a particular task onto a new date using this particular functionality. Now, the other thing what I want to do is I just want to consider a CSS class. Okay. I just want to consider a CSS class. Now here, if you observe the calendar one, by default, it shows all the tasks were in a particular, by default, a blue color, right? Now let us say If at all, if you want to show a different color based on the task tab, what you require is you require a specific CSS class to be applied based on the status. Now here there are standard CSS class which are already available by Apex. Now in this one, like if the pending, if it is a pending, it is a blue. If it is open, it's a green, like that. You know, I have just changed the SQL query. Now what I want to do is I want to apply the CSS class into this sample. So now what we can do is you just go to region here. Now we know that while creating the calendar, we have used the table directly, right? We have used the table directly. Now just click on attributes. Now scroll above. Okay. And sorry, not in the attributes, click on region, scroll above, and you should be able to see the table information, right? Now here, what is the source for this particular one? The source was table because we created our application based on the table logic. So obviously it will be having a table information, but nothing, no issue. What you do is change the type to SQL query, and that's it. It will automatically generate the query it is used by default. We does not need to worry about it. And only thing what we have to do is we just need to apply one more extra column. Okay. So I'll just apply this extra column, which is with the name CSS class. Okay. And click on save. Okay. Now, next thing is in the attributes, we just search for a column called CSS, and in the CSS class, apply this particular property, CSS class, and click on save. Now let's run the page and see how the look and feel will get changed. Got it? Based on the status, it got changed. Like we could able to see green, blue, gray, and orange. Okay. So this is all about a drag and drop functionality. Now, what is the other functionality we want to discuss is we want to see how do we create using a SQL query. See, the thing is when you're trying to create an application using the, when you're creating application using a table, by default, it was generating all the relevant pages for us so that we were able to simply, you know, like use the existing form. If not, what we have to do is we have to create the form explicitly. That's the only thing which I want to show you. Now, the final thing is the calendar app sample. So whatever I have discussed, many of the functionalities are from the Oracle provided samples only. Now, what you can do is if at all, if you want to get more deeper understanding on this particular calendar logic, what you do is click on gallery and click on samples. Make sure that you install this particular sample calendar. Okay. In this, we have very good number of samples. Okay. Where, you know, like which helps us to get more deeper understanding. Okay. Let me check out if I have already that one. Yeah, sample calendar. And I'll just run this one. Okay. So now here, yeah. So here, if you observe these number of sample calendar, I mean, like samples which are based on the calendars are available here, you can get more deeper understanding into these things. Okay. So this is all about the calendar functionality in Oracle Apex. Thank you.